change their gown or their pajamas, whatever, and change the linens and the sheets if they need it, pull it up to about here. Now, again, no autopsy. If there's equipment in the room, you want to get that out of the room, okay? Especially a suction machine that has a lot of you know, whatever has been suctioned out, you know, in there. You want to get that out. You know, a lot of cancers will produce different odors in the room, so you may want housekeeping to spray it just a little bit. So get that equipment out, get the head of the bed up, raise them up, get the cover pulled up to about here. And traditionally, this is what we do in nursing in America. The person has the appearance of sleeping. So when the family comes in, they're not inundated by equipment and by machines and by oxygen machines running and making noise. The beep, 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 if they have a cardiac monitor on them or if they have a pulse ox on them that's beeping and seeing all that, it looks, you know, the appearance of basically sleeping and rest. To make the emotional trauma of loss a little bit less, it's not that we're covering up death. It's obvious the person died, but we're trying to lessen the blow to the family that this has happened. So the person is in a comfortable, like sleep-like position to a certain extent. You might want to get some chairs in there for the family. Be sure and make sure that they have privacy. You know, you just kind of play it moment by moment, if you want to call it by ear, you can call it that, to what the family basically needs. Now, they may come in feeling numb or in shock. They may come in very quiet, they may come in very loud. You just don't know. People are going to express their feelings of this loss in different ways. Some of them may even have such symptoms as nausea or vomiting themselves, or difficulty breathing at the shock. Some may come in with a feeling of guilt, and especially if they've got unresolved issues or problems with the relationship with the one who's just passed away. Some may come in with denial of the whole death experience themselves. I was telling you in a previous video about our friend who just honey, wake up, and he called for my wife. You can come over here, wake her up. And, you know, just the shock of it, you know. Especially, you know, some of the hardest ones on me have been a parent holding their child. You know, because a lot of the parents, when they talk to me, it says, you know, Bob, your kid's not supposed to die before you do. And there have been some tough situations that I've been in. You know, you work trauma long enough and you're going to hold a lot of babies. You're going to hold a lot of toddlers. You know, that different car wrecks or falls or something has happened to them. And, you know, I have learned just to keep my mouth shut up and listen. Just be there. Hold the dad, hold the mom. There have been several times when I've gone out and just walk with the dad. You know, the female RN at the trauma center would walk with mom, and I'd just go walk with the dad, and we would go walk around on Meyer Boulevard or something like that just for a little while, and he would just talk and.